Peace and love, peace and love, peace and love, peace and love. Hey Soul Family, hey Soul Tribe. It's your girl, she's T'Shay, coming to you from Blackberry Fly with Thriving Thursday. Make sure you like, subscribe, share, and comment. Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost, I ask that you come into this place, come into my heart. I ask that it be none of me and all of you. Give me a clear, accurate message for the collective. Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost, have control. Sit on your throne, Baba. Alright. So we have. Thank you, angels, for surrounding me with people I can trust and love. Trustworthy friends. Thank you, family. Thank you, loved ones in heaven, for drawing close to me at this time. Your lost loved ones, family members, those guardian angels, your ancestors who are surrounding you, protecting you, watching over you, leading you, speaking to you. Thank you, universe and angels, for the blessings in my life. I got more than enough. I got more. I am more than enough. I am more, yay. Thank you, Miguel, for surrounding my life in a harmonious light. Thank you, Samuel, for removing the barriers from around my heart so I can receive these blessings and everything that is in store for me, okay? Oh yeah, I need to hit this. Open up the heart chakra. Thank you, Metatron, for clearing my energy field, as we just did. Yes, that heart chakra. Thank you, Santafon, for delivering my prayers to heaven. When prayers go up, those blessings come down. Thank you, angels, for lovingly guiding me to self-acceptance. I am more than enough. I am more. Yay. Thank you, angels. I breathe with ease knowing you are here. You got your angels, you got your ancestors, and you got God. Like, you ain't got nothing to worry about, boo. Thank you, Divine Mother, for helping me to give and receive the love I deserve. And the way I can do that is by clearing my energy field, by loving myself, and allowing myself to be loved as well. You know? Thank you, Uriel, for helping me to share my light with the world. Because you better. Why not? What you hiding it for? You're supposed to shine, beloved. Thank you, Raziel, for helping me channel my gifts and talents. Spiritual and physical. Thank you, angels, for blessing me with infinite abundance. I got more than enough. I got more. Thank you, angels. I trust your well-timed guidance and signs. Pay attention to the synchronicities. What are they saying to you? Thank you, heaven, for sending me reminders of your presence. Again, those synchronicities, seeing those colors or those different auras, seeing feathers, hearing messages, listening to your inner voice, and following that guidance, numerology, dreams, visions. What are you seeing? Pay attention. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and read from the Simple Abundance, A Daybook of Comfort and Joy. An Interior Vision Inventory. We shape our dwellings, and afterwards, our dwellings shape us, by Winston Churchill. The fantasy is that you simply start with a color, a couch, or a pine cupboard that you absolutely adore. So far, so good. What's next? Now you effortlessly put the room together, expressing through your dazzling creative choices, the carpet, the curtains, the crockery, the coffee table, the woman who loves art decor, or cozy English cottages. But what if today you suddenly don't know what you want to hang over the couch, lay on the floor, or put on the shelves? What if the couch came from your husband's first marriage, the carpet from your mother, the coffee table from Goodwill? What if you know what you want, but have to choose between that pine cupboard and a much needed new car? This then is time for an interior vision inventory. One of the benefits of sorting through your belongings and identifying what's beautiful, useful, and sentimental is that clarity emerges. You will probably be surprised by how much you already own that is simply waiting to be reconsidered, rearranged, reupholstered, refinished. Just don't be surprised to discover that even if what you live with is beautiful, it might no longer suit you. A dear friend of mine collected Keelum pillows with a passion for years. But one day, it occurred to her that she hadn't been spending as much time in the living room as in the past. Even though she invested a lot of money and energy to decorate it and she loved the look, she finally realized that the patterns were too busy to come home to after a rigorous and long day, and that the dark colors, while dramatic, depressed her. Torn between being practical, just letting the room stay the way it was, and discovering what truly pleased her now, she opted for pleasure. She not only wanted to bring the room to life, she needed to be able to live in it. Her new passion became peace of mind. The first step was to empty the room, leaving only the couches, when she recovered with plain white slip covers. But since the pillows are still beautiful, she sorted them until another setting invites their presence. The only color in the room comes from her beloved books. Her new personal flourish is restraint. Now when she comes home, she feels contented instead of uncomfortable, which, after all, is what authentic decorating should be about. Decorating shouldn't be about how a room looks in a magazine as much as how you feel in that room. If you are to create rooms with an authentic view, self-exploration must come before paint chips and fabric swatches. Personal flourishes can bridge the gap while we wait for our interior vision to find outward expression in our surroundings. Maybe you can't afford a new sofa just yet, but you could afford new pillow throws to give it a lift. Maybe you could give a lamp a new look with a different shade, arrange flowers in a teapot instead of a vase, find a pretty porcelain cup to hold pens, position a picture on a smart easel instead of a wall, hook a rug on your own design, take the doors off the kitchen cabinets, learn what you can live without. Personal flourishes can be had for little or no money if you are willing to invest passion, perseverance, patience, and a fresh perspective. The four P's: passion, perseverance, patience, and a fresh perspective. And that's how you should be carrying out your life, okay? You should not be surrounding yourself with things that do not reflect where you're trying to go, the things that you are trying to be, the person that you are becoming, okay? You have to set yourself up in a environment where you can thrive, and that also corresponds with the last Thriving Thursday talking about feng shui. Use those feng shui methods to create this environment and help bring in the necessary frequencies and vibrations that you need, okay? That uplifting, that encouraging, that inspiring, okay? That comfortable, that passionate, that home feeling, okay? So now we're just gonna go ahead and get a few quotes. Whatever you want, wants you, by Mark Victor Hansen. Whatever you want, wants you. You know why? Because that's what your soul wants. So when you send out that vibration into the world, the universe will respond to it. All right? That's what you need to be thinking about, the things that you want and how you can make it happen. Not the things that you don't want or the things that you don't like or the things that's failing. Make sure you are being solution oriented. Okay? We need a path not to go from here to there, but go from here to here. Exactly. You got to go from here to here. You already was there, okay? We don't need to go from here to there. We got to go from here to here, okay? And here corresponds with your life purpose, your soul's mission, the calling on you, okay? Let's do one more. One opens the inner doors of one's heart to the infinite silences of the spirit, out of whose abysses, love wells up without fail and gives itself to all. When you open up your heart, you open up it to infinite possibilities, okay? To get what you want, all right? To receive what you deserve, okay? To receive what you desire, all right? It's up to you, though. The four P's: passion, perseverance, patience, and perspective. Use those tools, use those skills, use those methods to help assist you with the clarity, to help assist you with bringing in, from taking you from here to here, okay? Bringing in new things, all right? Things that suit you, the you are now, okay? I love you all. That is all I have for today. I will be back Monday or Tuesday. Today is my birthday, so I'm not sure if I'll be back Monday because I will be coming back from out of town. If you want to book me for a reading, go to the About section, click on the link, and it will lead you to my booking site, or email me at blackbirdfly2i@gmail.com. Okay, I appreciate you. Celebrate life. It is beautiful. Every day is not guaranteed. How can you show up here, now, today, authentically and true to you? Okay, I love you all. Blessings, blessings, blessings. Namaste. I love this song, y'all. It speaks to me. It's my heart. My soul, my mind, my life. Take control. It's yours, Lord. Have your way. It's all I have to give. My heart. My mind. With my life. It's yours. It's all I have to give. Yes, Lord. It's all you got to give is your life, okay? How you showing up? Are you creating a life that suits you now? Not your past. Not that person you once were. The person you are now in this moment. The person you want to see, okay? I love you all. Mwah!